So basically the freehand line, that is a continuous freehand line, it is used to show the half part of a symmetric one. Okay, so we can draw such type of line. So this is the freehand line. It means that object is symmetric, it has same feature on the other side of the symmetric axis. Okay, the second use of the freehand drawing, freehand line, is we can show the cut section of the part. Okay, that means suppose we want to show the internal structure. So suppose this is the hollow cylinder, okay, and for this hollow cylinder, if you want to reveal the internal feature, then we can take the cut section like this. Okay, so representation of the cut section, it is done with the help of the freehand line. So you can see here, so this is the freehand line. Okay, that means we have removed the some portion of that geometry. Okay, and therefore the internal structure is visible, and this is the use of the freehand line. We can use it for the cut sections. The next type of line is, it is continuous thin, a zigzag line. So this is used for the long break line. So what is meaning of long break? So you can observe here. So suppose we have one component. Let us take the foundation of some machine part. Okay. So suppose we have this foundation like this. And on this foundation, a machine is mounted. Okay, like this. And this foundation, it has some features. So it has some holes. Okay, like this. And this dimension, this total dimension, is too long to fit this on the drawing paper. And therefore, we can remove or we can trim the some portion of this geometry, okay, where we don't have the feature included. So this portion, it doesn't have any feature. That means it doesn't have any hole or any other feature. So we can remove this and we can show this with the help of the zigzag line. So suppose if I observe this foundation from the top direction, okay, then from the top direction, we can observe a rectangular or a rectangle. Like this. Okay. But we are removing this portion. Okay, so that we can fit the given view. So to remove this portion, we can break this view and we can show this zigzag line. Okay, and then we can give the actual dimension. So suppose this total dimension is 2 meter. Okay, and suppose it has some feature like this, holes. And in this portion, there is no feature. So we have removed this and we can fit the given view on the drawing sheet. So this is the use to break the continuous view into two parts. So basically we are reducing the size of that complete view. So this is the use of the zigzag line. So you can read here, the long break lines, they are used when it is best to shorten the long view of an object. Okay. Then next is the dash line. So dash lines, they are used to show the hidden outlines or the hidden edges. So what is meaning of a hidden edge? So observe this second drawing. So this is one hollow cylinder. That means this cylinder, it is having the hole at the center. Okay. So if you observe from this front direction, then you can just observe the visible outline. Okay. So what is meaning of visible outline? You can observe this line. Okay. So basically this is the curve, but in the front view, you can just observe one straight line. That is a straight horizontal line. Then you will observe this vertical line. And again, this circle, that is a curve, as a straight line. Okay. So in the front view, you can just observe a rectangle. Okay. So this rectangle, it will have the dimension. Suppose this is the edge. And it has some diameter D. So its rectangle will be height H. And its width will be equal to the diameter. Okay. But in the front view, observer cannot observe the hidden part. Okay. So how we can show the existence of this hidden part in the two-dimensional paper? So its existence is shown with the help of the dotted lines. So dotted lines means what? They will represent this edge. Okay. So we will show this with the help of the dotted line. So this dotted line, they will represent the hidden feature or the hidden geometry. So this is the use of the dotted line. It is used to represent the hidden part. Then the next type, it is the chain thin long dash dotted narrow line. So such type of line, it is used for the center line, line of symmetry, trajectory, pitch circle of the gears, or pitch circle of the holes. Okay. So you can observe here the use of chain line. So chain line first is used for the center line or the symmetry. That means if any part is symmetrical about a particular axis, then we will use such type of line. Okay. So this is how we can draw this line. So you can observe here, this is the circle and it has some features. Okay. So it is symmetrical about this axis and at the same time, it is symmetrical about this axis. And to represent this symmetric axis, we will use this line. So this complete line, which is drawn here, it is nothing but the chain line. Okay. The second use of this line is it is used for the pitch circle. So what is meaning of a pitch circle? Suppose any feature is at equal distance from the center. Okay. So suppose we have one object which is circular. Okay. And this is the center. And on this object, it has the holes at equal distance. That means at the radius. Okay. So all these holes, they are made at the same distance with respect to the center. So we can represent the position of all these holes with the help of one circle. Okay. And this circle, it is called as a pitch circle. Because all these holes, or we can say all these features, they are present in the geometry at the equal radius. Okay. So this pitch circle, it is represented with the help of the chain line. So we need to draw this circle like this. So then we can say it is nothing but the pitch circle. So this is the representation of the pitch circle. So you can observe here in the given drawing sheet, this is the pitch circle. Okay. So this is the use of the chain line. Then the next type, it is the chain thin with thick ends. So this is the chain thin line having the thick edges. So this is used to represent the cutting plane position. So what is meaning of a cutting plane position? So in the engineering graphics, we will prepare some drawings where the object is cut by some imaginary plane. Okay, and for the remaining portion, we will prepare the drawing. So you can observe here, we have one cone. And this cone is cut by one inclined plane. So this is called as a cutting plane. Okay, so after cutting this cone by using this cutting plane, we will draw the drawing only for the portion which is remaining. Okay, so remaining portion is the portion which is just below this cutting plane. So in the drawing, suppose the observer is looking at this object from the front direction. So from the front direction, the visible geometry, it will be just one triangle. Okay. So to prepare the drawing, when the object is cut by this cutting plane, we have to show the position of this cutting plane. So cutting plane is like this. Okay. And this is the remaining portion. So this remaining portion, it is shown with the help of the continuous thick line, that means visible outline. This upper portion, that is apex, it is being removed. So we will not show this geometry, that means this portion in the drawing. Okay. So this cutting plane, it is shown with the help of the thin chain line with the thick edges. That means we have to draw the chain line here. And we have to show the thick edges. Okay, so this represents the cutting plane. So this is the difference between a thin chain line and the thin chain line with the thick edges. So these are the main types of line that we are going to use to prepare the drawing. So I hope the all types and their applications are clear. Now next part, it is the dimensioning. So what is dimensioning? In the dimensioning, we provide the information about the length, breadth, diameter, and also if there is any note to be given about the feature. So this complete part is called as a dimension. So what are the important points in the dimensioning? The first is the dimension line. So we will draw the dimensioning line generally which parallel to the feature. Okay. So dimension line, it is drawn with the line type which is continuous thin. Okay, so generally it is drawn with the edge pencil. At the end of this dimension line, we need to specify the arrowhead. So arrowhead is drawn like this. So this arrowhead, it should not be hollow, so it must be a solid arrowhead. And this ratio, it is 3:1. Okay, so if you are specifying this as a x dimension, then its length must be 3x. Okay, so this is the representation of the arrowhead. Then after arrowhead, we will specify the extension line. Okay, so this line will be extended from the actual feature. Okay, so the extension line, again it is continuous thin line. And we need to specify this dimension generally at distance 6 to 8 mm from the feature. Okay. So what are the methods to specify the dimensions? So first method is align dimension method, and second is the unidirectional dimension method. Okay. So in the align dimension method, the first dimension, so here first drawing, it is for the align dimension method. And second, it is the unidirectional. So what is the difference between the aligned dimension method and the unidirectional is, you can observe, in the aligned dimension method, dimensions are written perpendicular to the dimension line. Okay, that means, suppose we have one rectangle and we want to specify its length. So we will draw the dimension line. This is the extension line, okay? And we will write the dimension. Suppose it is 30 mm, okay? Suppose we want to specify its width. So we will draw the dimension line like this, and we will write the dimension, which is perpendicular. So this is the perpendicular line. So suppose it is 10 mm or 20 mm. So this is written like this. So this is called as the align dimension method. Okay. So what is the unidirectional dimension method? In the unidirectional dimension method, we can read all the dimensions from the bottom side. Okay. So here you can observe all the dimensions written in these directions, in the vertical direction only. So we can read all these dimensions just from the bottom of the drawing. Okay. So unidirectional, this is used when we prepare the large drawing sheets. So this unidirectional method, it will avoid the difficulty in order to read the dimension of the drawing for the large drawing sheets. Okay, so this is the basic difference between align method and the unidirectional method. So where do we exactly use the unidirectional method? So generally it is used for the large drawing sheets. Okay, so to prepare the drawings for the automobile, then aeroplanes, ships. Okay, so this is the basic methods that is used for the align, used for the dimensioning. One is align and unidirectional. So from the next lecture, we will study the rules for the dimensioning. So today we will stop here.